KFC Old World Jets edged newly promoted Trafalgar South Stars 2-1 on Saturday night at the Warner Park in a match that could have gone either way. Kalon Liburd got things rolling for Old World with a goal in the 26th minute, but Sean Percival of Trafalgar South Stars equalized for the Premier League newbies in the 60th minute with a towering header in the danger zone. But not before long, Old Road regained the lead from the penalty spot after a defender handled the ball inside the box, which was easily slotted home by Lance Lewis in the 80th minute. Old Road had a chance to extend the lead in the end, again from the penalty spot, but South Stars goalkeeper Zaquel Brown this time guessed correctly to stop the shot and keep the scoreline 2-1, in literally the last play of the match. Coach Alexis Morris of Old Road said even though his team won, they made the match harder than it had to be.
First of all, let me say tip my hat to the Trafalgar South Stars team. I think it's a team in the making. They're putting a lot of things together, and you can see with Jevon Francis in the forefront of them. It's going to become a good team. And however, I want to say to my team, congratulations on the 3 points. I think that we made the game more difficult than it should have been for us. Some of the key points that we placed on them, they basically went away from it. And it cost us a bit. As you said, that goal that South Stars would have scored, we saw the defender backing up and allow the cross. And that is something we definitely can't allow. And so therefore, guys on the pitch just have to continue to be disciplined, continue to carry out instructions, and things would be okay. We continue this, as you would have seen, basically for the season so far. We basically just have about one or two goals that they want to play. And tonight I saw that we have created a numerous number of chances and we failed to score. So, as you can see, we are lacking in the final third department, but we are going to get it right. We have a lot of players out at this point in time because of, it's no secret, because of discipline reasons. And once they're back, the OR team would be a team to be reckoned with. So we're just awaiting. As you can see, this is second straight game and we was very short-handed in terms of players.
Coach Morris took over Old Road this season after spending several years coaching Connery FC, even leading them to a title in 2013. Coaching Old Road is a different experience altogether, he said, but one he relishes.
First of all, after the Connery team, I must say that I really wanted a break from the game because I've been going for quite a while and I really wanted a break from the game, but I was approached by a number of players that I would have coached at the Virtues High School, and they asked me to come and lend them a helping hand, knowing that I'm living in the area. It was a welcome thing and I did it. I went. And I thought that I must say that they welcomed me with open arms. They're basically now, in terms of what we're working on, you can see that the players, they're loving it. They are eager to learn. They're eager to go forward. And we just, as we said before, as long as the guys continue to be disciplined and they come out to train, the OR team would be a team to be reckoned with in the future. But all in all, I think that they are buying into to the new style of football that we are looking at OR.
Meanwhile, Zaquel Brown, the Trafalgar South Stars goalkeeper, was thrilled to have saved his team from conceding another goal in virtually the last play of the match from the penalty spot. He walked us through how he managed to save the shot.
It was a good penalty, as was said. It was good, and the first penalty he went to his right, so I guess he will switch to the other left at the corner. So I just did that, and the choice was right. In all, we played a better game from the first half. After we scored, we had more momentum. But then and we lost a penalty. It cost us the second goal. We fought harder, but it was just unfortunate that we lost.
He believes the team can pick themselves up from this defeat and move on to do great things in the Premier League.
Well, we've been training hard, extra hard. As we could see, we're at the bottom of the table. So we got promotion, like we got energy to show that we're willing to win a game. So we work from there, train again, train hard, come back for the next game, and then we see what happens from there.
In other Premier League results on Sunday, SL Horsa St. Paul's United defeated Atiba Harry St. Peter's 3-0. Heathrow Freeman had two goals in the 10th and 58th minutes, and Omar Francis in the 13th minute. Then in the second match of the triple header, Saul Allen Autosupplies Connery FC crushed Mantab 4-0. Kadeem Lewis scored two goals in the second and 39th minute, Yusen Slater in the 65th minute, and Tijani Fai in the 82nd minute. And finally on Sunday, Ransville Superstars took on Fastcast Saddlers, defeating them 3-1. Kimari Rogers scored in the second minute of stoppage time in the first half, Tyrann Hanley scoring two goals in the 52nd minute from the penalty spot and the 88th minute. The lone goal for Saddlers came from Tariq Morris in the third minute of stoppage time. Trevor Hanley of Saddlers was issued a straight red card after picking up two yellow cards in the 23rd and 57th minutes. The next Premier League matches will be on Tuesday, January 28th, where Hobson Enterprises' Garden Hotspurs will take on Elko Limited Security Forces United at 6 p.m. and at 8 p.m. Escrave Newtown United playing Flow 4GK on Rockets. Both games will be at the Warner Park Football Stadium.